This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. This is part two of vector basics. So in this video, we'll draw vectors on a graph if we are given their components, and then we'll find their magnitude, which is their length, and we'll learn the notation used for the magnitude of a vector. All right. So here's the first one. It says, draw each vector on a graph and state its magnitude. Okay, the first thing to remember, there's a lot of places you could place each vector. There's not just one place, but I thought it might be easier if we have kind of a graph, so it's easier to see exactly where, you know, you might start and end when. So why don't you try these on your own? First of all, just see if you can draw vector B. Right, so an easy way is to start at the origin, but it's unnecessary. You could start anywhere you want, but wherever you start, to get to the ending point, you're going to have to go this first component. Negative 4 means go to the left 4. And then the second component tells you how far to go up or down. So if I happen to start at the origin, I can go to the left 4, and I could go down 3. And that's where it ends, and I started there, and that is vector V. Okay, that's one place you could put vector V. That's what it looks like, but this graph can be completely erased, et cetera, as long as each unit looks the same as it does here, and that's where it is. So somebody else may have decided to start it right here. Okay, there's the beginning, and they're going to go 4 to the left, 1, 2, 3, 4, and down 1. I'm sorry, down 3. And it might look like this. So there's a lot of places you could put it. What is true about it, though, is the direction always looks the same, and the length always looks the same. So, you know, they also look parallel if you had put, they're on two parallel lines, right? So that's also true. We'll do the magnitude in a minute. All right, how about W, that vector? Again, to make it simple, I'm just going to start at the origin. I'm going to go 2 to the right and down 1. And there's one way, there's one place you could put W. You could also put it, you know, right here. I could start here and go over 2 and down 1, right? I could start right here and go over 2 and down 1. So there's a lot of places it could be placed, infinitely many places it can be placed. Okay, second question, state its magnitude. So that means we want to know how long that is. The easiest way to do that is just to make a right triangle out of it. So let's look at this right triangle right here. This is a length of 3, and that's a length of 4. And how would you find that length here? You could use the Pythagorean Theorem to get how long this vector is, which is its magnitude. So for V, the magnitude, now let's see, if you're not sure what it is, it's that the hypotenuse squared, I'll call c squared, is going to be 4 squared plus 3 squared. Well, that's 16 plus 9, or 25. So the length of the magnitude of V would be 5, the square root of 25. Okay, so that's the magnitude of V. And the notation we use for that is these, I put the V in here. You could put either like an absolute value and you say the magnitude is, I put C, I meant 5. But, okay, just to make it confusing, you also see this notation, 2 bars. Okay, so there's two ways that people use to write the magnitude of a vector or the length of a vector. So for V, it would be 5. Now, how about the other one? Here's our other vector. So we have 2 and 1. Again, using the Pythagorean Theorem, we can do the square root. We're going to have, let's say we're trying to find this length C again. I'll say C squared would be 2 squared plus 1 squared. So C squared is 5. So that length would be square root of 5, right? So the magnitude, I'm going to use double bars. Like I said, two ways to do it. The magnitude of vector W is the square root of 5. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.